Hi, hello, namaskara. In this section of our video series, we'll be discussing a concept called as magnetic flux density. Magnetic flux density is usually referred with the character B. So it is called as magnetic flux density. But what is magnetic flux density? If you remember our electrostatics, where we had defined something called as electric flux density, which was defined over D. In a similar way, in magnetostatics, I will be calling magnetic flux density. The relation between my magnetic flux density and the magnetic field intensity can be defined as that of I related in my electrostatics with respect to electric field intensity and electric flux density. If you remember, electric field intensity and electric flux density was related by this expression, where D is equal to epsilon naught E, where epsilon naught was called as the permittivity of free space. In a similar fashion, I can compare my magnetic flux density and the magnetic field intensity with something called as mu naught, where mu naught is called as permeability of free space, okay, where this permeability is having the value 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 Henry per meter. So this is how we relate a magnetic field intensity to magnetic flux density in a free space. We know that magnetic flux density B is having an SI unit of Weber per meter square. That means to say, it defines what is the amount of flux lines. Weber is nothing but it is SI unit of flux lines. Flux lines means to say, if I say this is my lines of force from a magnet which is crossing an area, okay, if this is some area, this is some flux line that is passing. So B is usually given by the flux lines that is passing per meter square of area, okay. So usually this flux lines will be passing that particular area in right angles. So sometimes it will not be passing right angles, it might be passing in a crooked manner. Say for example, I'll be representing that in this fashion. So it might be going something like this. I have an area like this, but it is not exactly right angle. So at that time, what we can define is, I can define the flux lines as, usually flux lines in our electrostatics was also defined with the help of psi. Here also, in the magnetostatics, I'll be using the same representation psi, but psi is represented as the surface integral of B dot ds, okay, where the unit of psi is Weber's. So I can see this B corresponds to Weber per meter square, and this corresponds to meter square. The area is a length into breadth or x into y. So this both get cancelled, and this is the SI unit of my flux density, the magnetic flux density. Okay. Now if I say, usually there is a current that is flowing. So let me represent, this is my current vector. So that means to say, my current I is coming out of this board, or if it is coming out of the screen, I'm showing the vector of the current. So how will the flux lines be if I use my thumb rule, the right hand thumb rule? The flux lines will be revolving around this, right? It will be revolving around this in this fashion, and the lines of force will be in this direction. Agree? Everyone does agree for this? Since the current is flowing out of this board, if I use the thumb rule, right hand thumb rule, thumb corresponds to the direction of current. Hence, my fingers, the other fingers, should correspond to the magnetic field around that conductor. Hence, this is a magnetic field. So there is an experiment, like if I place a compass near this, compass is nothing but which shows the direction. The compass, in that compass you will be having arrow marks usually. So the north and south, this is how the compass will be getting aligned. So if you want, you can just have an experiment on this. So the north will be always having an exiting pole and the south will be having entry pole. Similarly, if I show a normal bar magnet, where basically they represent one part to be a north pole and other part to be a south pole, my field lines will be usually exiting from the north pole and it will be ending up at south pole. You would have seen all this type of experiments in your schooling. Okay, so this is how my field lines will be going and coming. But the concept here I'm interested here to speak is like that of electrostatics, where electrostatics you had a plus Q charge and a minus Q charge, like you had a positive charge and negative charge separated. You had dipoles, you had two poles, okay, two charges were there. In magnetostatics, I don't have such two charge concept. So it is a one whole thing. So if I consider a closed path, like if I take some path like this, consider I'm taking a path like this, and I'm trying to calculate the flux that is entering this. If you see this magnet, actually the force of lines internally flows through, right? So if I take a closed path integral of this particular expression, so closed integral of B dot ds, I can say that is equal to zero. You might wonder why, how, like what. You can, if I say the surface, whatever the flux that is entering that surface is also leaving the surface at the other end. You can see what are the flux that is entering here. So it is entering point, it is leaving at this point. So the total flux that is available within the surface is what? It is zero, right? That's what this integral states. The closed integral is what are the field lines that is entering that particular surface. I'm adding up. So whatever is added up, it is also getting subtracted at the other end. Hence, this integral in a closed loop manner will be equal to zero, and it's always equal to zero in magnetostatics. Why? Because if I take this magnet and if I somehow divide into two pieces, this magnet now will be acting as a two individual bar magnets. And I think probably you will be knowing this concepts, right? Even if I split these things now, I'll split like this, this again starts to act as another two bar magnets. So this will be north, this will be south. So I have four magnets now. Hence, in magnets, I can't have different poles separated together or two unique poles. I cannot have that. Monopoles are not available in bar magnets, or in any magnets, monopoles are not available. So keep that in mind. Monopoles doesn't exist. in magnetism or magnetostatics. So with this concept, what I do now is I got to know that the closed integral or closed surface integral of B dot ds is equal to zero. If you remember our Gauss divergence theorem, where the divergence theorem stated, okay, I'll express that also. Closed surface integral of D dot ds can be changed to volume integral of del dot d dv, right? If I apply divergence theorem here, what I have is the closed surface integral can be written as the volume integral, where I have del dot, instead of d, I have to replace that with b, dv is equal to 0. If this integral is 0, obviously the volume cannot be equal to 0. At any time, the volume doesn't exist to 0. Hence, the only thing that can be equated to 0 is my field lines, or the flux density, that divergence of the flux density. So this equation becomes del dot b is equal to 0. So this is one more important expression of Maxwell. This is called as the Gauss law in differential form for magnetic fields. Okay, for magnetic fields, keep that in mind, for magnetic fields, because we are speaking about magnetism here. So for magnetic fields, this is the Gauss law, and this is in the point form, because it is in the differential form, hence it is the point form. I can specify this point form of Gauss law, and this is one of the important Maxwell's equations. Maxwell's equation, point form Gauss law for magnetic, in terms of magnetic fields. So what it states is, what this expression or what this equation states is, if I have a closed volume or a surface, the amount of magnetic flux that is getting diverged out, the magnetic field or the magnetic flux lines that is getting diverged out, is always equal to zero, because whatever is getting exited will be entering at some point, because my magnetic field lines are loop or closed loop. They are not open in nature. They are always closed loop. You don't have a termination. It's like, that's what we just explained here. You can't say the magnetic field got terminated at South Pole. It flows through and it again emerges out at the North Pole. Hence, there is no termination like that of my charges, where I had a termination at negative charge, positive to negative. Okay, so this is the concept of magnetic flux density, and this is one of the main equations of the four Maxwell's important equations which we have seen in electrostatics. Hope this is understood. Please feel free to just do some more research in this topic. If you have any doubts, contact me. I'll help you out. Thank you.